Now I am using the drowning torture technique to interrogate the car. I must know all of its secrets. It must have secrets. So this was a 1 hour and 40 minute video of uncut footage, and now it's less than 10 minutes, so yeah, I'm such a good editor, yay! Hey guys, it's me. Today is going to be like a set video, like where I'm making a set, but I'm not actually making a set, if that makes sense. In the most recent episode of LPS Mistake, we see Michael's car, he gets in an accident, spoiler alert, he gets in an accident, and the car, well, we're gonna say it's totaled. That's the story I'm going with. It's destroyed. So he needs a new car. Now, this car is actually the LPS Blythe set car. It's purple, it's white, you see it in episode 10. Problem is that this one I don't think I can use in the future for any videos because for some reason it's sticky. Like the seats where the LPS would be standing or sitting are sticky, and so I don't want to use it for videos. Black paint transferred onto the LPS, and so I will not be using this car anymore. Michael will need a new car anyway for the series, and so I will just take off all the paint off of this one and start over. You know, start fresh. Here's what the original car looked like. Here is what Michael's car looks like in season 2, up until episode 5. I wanted to get all of the dust off of the car before removing the paint, so I just plopped it in a big bucket of water and soap. I wanted to see if any paint would come off in the water. This is where you can see the paint transfer from the inside of the car, that sticky part that I was talking about. For some reason, the texture is different on the seatbelt and on the steering wheel. Here is the car slowly sinking into the water. This is sped up. I thought it was just fun. I'm just gonna leave it here. I was going to disassemble the car to paint the wheels and the body separate, only to find out after over 20 minutes that I could not do so. So, no need for that footage. That's all gone deleted now. Wow, what a waste of time. I removed the paint with 100% acetone nail polish remover and cotton pads. I'm wearing gloves and a mask to make myself more comfortable. I removed the paint. I got pretty far, but now I have all this mess, and now there's fuzz from the cotton pads on the car, which, ew. So I tossed the car in the water bucket, and I'm beating myself up over the fact that I could have very well have just painted over the black car and took the paint off of the inside, the interior of the car. And yeah, now I know. Just a bit late. I threatened the car with a hammer and then ultimately decided to remove the sticky seatbelt. I do not recommend doing this to real cars. Seatbelts are important. Very important. I'm going to be using an airbrush to paint on the base coat of this car. So I need my air pressurizer, I need my airbrush tool thing. I've got some paint, and now we're just going to paint the wheels black because I could not remove them, so I'm just going to paint them first. So I'm painting those black as well as the interior of the car. I am painting
black as well. This paint is different from what I used on Michael's original black car. That was just black spray paint in a can from the dollar store. This time we're using water-based airbrush paints. So yeah, moving up in the world, I guess. It does take longer though. So the only thing that is a different texture than anything else in the car is the steering wheel. So we'll see how it holds up and see if it doesn't get sticky. So yeah, we've got the interior, we've got the seats, we've got the windshield, we have all of that. And so I have put green painter's tape around those bits that were black just to protect them so that they don't get sprayed. And I'm just going in with green. I was just using the green out of the bottle that I had. It's very, very green. It's very green. So I ended up adding black to the mixture, making it a darker green, and that's suiting the car much better. It looks very good. I like it. Yeah, as you can see, like in this shot, it looks better. Using acrylic paint, this is just from the dollar store. Got red, yellow, and orange. I've got some paintbrushes, some weird sponges, a scrubby. I just want to get a rusted texture. And a lot of cars, when I was searching up inspiration, just pictures online, the rust always starts at the rims of the car, where the wheels are at, and then kind of move their way up. And so I decided to just all of the rims is where I kind of started. And yeah, I sped this up. I used the scrubby and the sponges because I wanted there to be like a rust texture. Very textured-y, very, if that's a word, very rough, scrapey, scratchy, I don't really know, just textured, if that makes sense. So I'm going in with a red-orange combo, some just plain orange, a more brighter orange with the yellow. I just wanted a bunch of different layers to the rust and different colors to the rust. And yeah, so you're not gonna see the whole process. Like if I have like, I have over an hour of just me sponging on orange paint, it'd probably be very boring. So I actually cut the video off at this point and just did it all off camera. So to seal it all in, I am just using a matte clear spray, and here is the end result. So I really like it. The car is green in theory, and it's rusted all around the entire car. It probably started up from just being rusted at the rims, and then it wasn't treated or fixed, and so it got worse. And there are rust like drip stains, like I don't really understand. I saw it in a lot of the photos. There's also the wheels are different colors. Some are just black and some have the lighter gray. This is just to be like, hey look, the tires don't match. Some are probably older. One of them might be a spare tire that they just never took off. And yeah, so I just wanted really textured, really textured. And that's the end result. Hope you like it.